Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. I shall, by God's help, speak to you about stars and a star. Most of you have at one time or another either been to a movie or looked at one on a television screen and watched a story unfold by actors and actresses, sometimes a true story of an historical event and sometimes fiction. And the main or featured characters in the play are known as stars, movie or stage stars. They shine on the moving picture screen in the neighborhood and downtown theaters, on the TV screens in taverns and other public places, and more often on the TV in our own homes. And the star is sometimes killed in the picture, but most times he or she turns out to be the hero. A man who owns a lovely home in Chicago and another even finer in California stepped into a prize fighter's ring a few years ago and became the champion fighter of the world, the star of the boxing world. And in other professions, men and women have done likewise. Yeah. And now we hope to bring you a few words about Virgin Mary's Christmas gift. And our subject again, stars. And a star. Most churches and pastors have already exhausted every word, thought, and deed which pertains to the miraculous conception of Jesus, the Christ of God, from the promise of a Redeemer for the sins of Israel to the portion of the great news that at long last he's here. The word was not sent by a runner or by the postman or a special delivery man, but by an angel, a member of and joined by a heavenly host who sounded off with a song bearing the words, "Glory to God in the highest and peace on earth to good doers and those whose will is to do good." All right. Their audience was a group of sheep herders who huddled together on one of the hills of Judea from whence they could watch their sheep. The song amazed them and awakened them in time to hear a startling announcement that the day had come for a bundle from heaven to arrive on earth. A little boy who would someday reign on earth, a supreme potentate, a governor of the universe, and a savior of lost souls everywhere. He was to be found in a stable meant for horses and cows, with a manger, an animal food trough, for his bed. This represented a step out of eternity and down into time. While this is taking place, we look into the heavens as three astrologers, stargazers, if you please, who told of a strange occurrence to them. Male choir Gasper and Belthazar, three seekers of truth, love, and justice, introduced themselves as from another country, which lay east of Jerusalem, and related to King Herod their familiarity with heavenly planets, how they, while going about the study of the heavens, found that although Jupiter, Mars, and Venus were familiar to them, there was another star, completely different from the others. Different from the morning and evening star, as well as unlike the Star of David, the North Star, whose fixed position to the Big Dipper helps us to find directions by saying, if I face that North Star, that means my back is to the south. To my left will have to be the west, and that leaves the east on my right. And as a pastor of this great church, Reverend Clay Evans would say it about this time, can I get a witness? They told King Herod, the ruler of that province, how many tedious hours they had spent on the road, and by night especially, as they followed this strange but fascinating star from place to place, as it led them toward Jerusalem, and thinking that surely the king would know about this newborn babe who was born King of the Jews. But most babies, male children, born in the palace are trained and taught that someday, after they have grown up, and when the king, their father, went to his grave, the oldest son living would be crowned king in his stead. But the speaker for this trio of wise men said in the King James Version of the Bible, "We have seen his star in the east, and it led us this far. So knowing that it should be born in your palace, since you are the king, right? So tell us where we'll find this baby who is born king of the Jews. Not to be a king after a while, but already born king of the Jews. We don't know why he wasn't to be named Herod Jr., but come to think about it, he seems to have had a long history of names. Some we could deal with and understand, and some of his names and titles didn't seem to make too much sense nohow. One writer must have had a far-sighted vision, and he called him the root and offspring of David. And another said he's a root out of a dry ground. Somebody said, "It appears to me that when I think about him, a sweet odor passes before me, and it makes me think of him as a lily that grows in the valley, or the rose from a little place called Sharon." Can I get another witness? Let the real saint say, "Yes, Lord." Lift your hands to him and tell him yes. And while you have him up with you, clap those hands. And one more time, say yes. Somebody else looked into the sky and said, "He's a bright and morning star." And finally, the prophet Isaiah said, "Let me take a look into the telescope of time and see what I can see." While he's looking, I hear him saying unto us, "A child is given. It's 700 years before he is due. But that's all right. I see what sex it is. Unto us, a son is born. He's going to be a great and powerful politician, because the government of the world shall be upon his shoulders." Hallelujah. And he's far too great for any one name. He's far too great for any one title. So let me list a few of each. He said, "His name shall be called Wonderful. Another name shall be Counselor. His name shall be called Mighty God. His name shall be called Everlasting Father. His name shall be called Prince of Peace." Let the real saints say yes. The three wise men, like other wise men who still do today, they see whatever is around them. They look behind and see what's there. They try to look in the future and see what befalls them later on. And they said, "We're familiar with the stars of the sky. We can call a whole lot of them by name, but we've got to add another name to this list by calling the star that led them over mountains and streams, led them over rocks and rills, over rivers and through valleys. The star that led on from Jerusalem to Bethlehem, down the main street to one of the town's hotels. But the innkeeper said, 'No one registered here that's expecting a baby.' But then somebody remembered that there was a stranger in town who had a wife and told them, you might find them around in the stable, because there's no room, there's no room for him in the inn. Hallelujah. Wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. But I'm sure they've decided by this time that something must be wrong. Something ain't working out like it's supposed to be. Imagine a king being born in a stable. The smell of the manure on the dirt floor. The lowing of an ox. The braying of a mule. Surely, this couldn't be real. But I hear one of the wise men, probably Melchior, saying to the other two, Gaspar and Balthazar, step back out the door. Look up. See if you can see that star. The one that we've been following.
Subscribe to Brother Rollins' videos for Christ on YouTube. We post brand new content every week with powerful preaching from ministers and pastors all across the nation that seek to encourage people all over the world through the word of Jesus Christ. You will also find gospel songs and old-time hymns that have inspired generations of Christians. Subscribe today and hit the bell so you never miss new content. YouTube.com/Brother Rollins. Spell it. B-R-O-T-H-A Rollins. Brother Rollins' videos for Christ on YouTube.